Introducing Narad Muni. Lord Brahma, at the instance of Lord Krishna, created Narad Muni along with other rishis such as Angira, Marichi, etc. Narad Muni was an ardent devotee of Lord Krishna since his very birth. He always enjoyed singing the glories of Lord Krishna. Moved by his bhakti, Lord gifted him a wonderful musical instrument called Veena. Narad Muni traversed all over the world, happily singing the glories of Lord Krishna to the fascinating tune of Veena. With the aim of populating the universe with more living beings, Lord Brahma asked his son Narad Muni to refrain from roaming with Veena and instead settle down by getting married and establish a lineage. But Narad Muni declined to accept his advice on the plea that family bondage is the cause of sorrow, and he preferred singing the glories of Lord to getting attached to any worldly affair. Narad Muni's denial infuriated Lord Brahma, and he cursed him to lead the life of a Gandharva, celestial singer, for one kalpa. One kalpa is Lord Brahma's one day and is equal to 432 million solar years. Narad Muni was then born to the Gandharva class of demigods and became known as Upabarhana. He was a cherubic musician and hence capable of alluring beautiful women. As his fame circulated far and wide, he became high-minded. Once, all the Gandharvas were participating in a musical fest, and in the fest, while all were singing and dancing as per agreeable rhythm, Upabarhana missed a particular rag or beat as he got distracted by the charm of a woman around him. The demigods, displeased at his unbecoming behavior, cursed him to be born as a low-class Shudra. Thus, Narad Muni was born to a maidservant in his next birth on earth. Though Narad Muni was born to a maidservant, his last two births were in his memory because of Lord Krishna's mercy. When a few sages arrived to stay at his home during Chaturmasya, he served them with utmost care and gave up playing, even though he was only 4 years old. The sages taught him about Bhakti Marg, and he got the opportunity to take the leftover foodstuffs of the sages as prasadam. This made him spiritually elevated, and all his past misdeeds got dissolved. As a result, he got back his life as the son of Lord Brahma and started treading on the path of bhakti by once again playing Veena and singing the glories of Lord Krishna. Narad Muni was ever enthusiastic to guide people on the path of spirituality and consequently became the spiritual master to many. Bhakta Prahlad was one of them. Prahlad's father Hiranyakashipu was a tyrannical demon ruler. He migrated to the mountain forest of Mandirachal to practice severe austerities to enhance his demoniac powers. Taking advantage of his absence, the demigods attacked his kingdom. The demigods got hold of the pregnant wife of Hiranyakashipu and held her captive so that they could kill the newborn and stop the blooming of another Hiranyakashipu. However, Narad Muni came to the rescue of the child, and he urged the demigods to free Prahlad's mother, as her forthcoming issue was destined to be a great devotee of the Supreme Lord. The demigods then immediately released her with due honor and returned to their respective kingdoms. Nal Kuver and Manigrive were the sons of Kuvera, the treasurer of demigods. In their youth, they became addicted to wine and women. One day, they were senselessly playing with a woman in a lake, in unclothed condition. They were so unmindful of the outside world that they could not see Narad Muni passing by. This lack of decency enraged Naramuni, and he cursed these fallen brothers to become Amal Arjuna trees in the courtyard of Krishna's residence in Vrindavan. As trees, they remained naked and exposed to heat, cold, rain, etc. for 100 years, and they were relieved from their distress by little Krishna. Narad Muni also preached the philosophy of Krishna consciousness to Mrigari. Mrigari was a very cruel hunter who half-killed animals and made them suffer. Due to Narad Muni's association, he left all his bad habits and became compassionate towards all living creatures, including ants. The great Narad Muni was amazed to see Dhruva, the son of Uttanapad, yearning for God at a very tender age. Narad Muni showed mercy on the boy and initiated him with the time-tested mantra, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. To get proximity of the Supreme Godhead. Once, Srila Vyasadeva, disciple of Narad Muni, was dissatisfied with the shortcomings of his compilation of Vedic literatures. Narad Muni knew the reason of Vyasadeva's discontentment through his sharp intellect, and he advised him to compile Srimad Bhagavatam with direct tales in order to glorify the activities of the Supreme Lord and let people know the supreme goal of life. Lord Brahma, also known as Adikavi, was enlightened by the Supreme Lord Sri Krishna, and Lord Brahma in turn rendered the acquired knowledge to his son Narad. Narad Muni passed down the same without any alteration to his famous disciple Srila Vyasadeva. The process continued through a chain of successors to the present day. The followers of Brahma Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya originate from Narad Muni, as they worship deities in accordance with the directions given in Narada Pancharatra or Narada Pancharatrika Vidhi. Narad Muni ki jai!